For every girl who goes into computer science, people say like, yeah, you're such a role model for girls, but people don't say to any guy in computer science like, wow, how do you feel about being a role model for all these like young guys? No one says that to them, so they don't have that problem.
I always knew I wanted to be an electrical engineer, but the constant rhetoric around women in science, that was something that actually stuck with me.
I'm studying biomedical sciences, and I'm just in this phase of figuring it all out, what I would like to do and what I value most.
I like actually really like computer science, but it wasn't something that my parents expected of me, or I guess the people around me thought I would do. And I guess a lot of me wonders if that's because I am a girl.
There's still such a need for inclusion in science and diversity. I still think that we don't feel very comfortable in those spaces, and we still feel like it's a very dominated field. And I think that it's important for women of all ages who would like to pursue careers in science to know that they are valued.
The whole notion that girls don't do math or science is why we don't have girls in STEM. My whole mission is to change that. We're going to be traveling
in an RV. We're going to start in Boston and then go west until we hit the Bay Area in California.
And interview about 20 women who are leading professionals in science to inspire our next generation of women in STEM.
The reason that I joined this trip is because I'm still trying to figure out what I want to do in life.
Me too.
I think that's kind of why we're all here.
I would really like to know what obstacles they've had to tackle. What got you involved in science? How did you decide on your career? How did you find your passion? I think it'll be very influential on finding out how to create my own road in life.
What's your name again?
Elicia.
Elicia?
Just tell us about how you got to the point you are now.
I was kind of doing what you guys are. I was scared. I found the ending of college to be terrifying.
Every step along the way, there have been people around me who constantly question, why are you here? People have expectations of what I should do, and they can have their expectations. It has nothing to do with what I'm going to do.
I hear her struggles and how she still became something so amazing going through the same things.
I want to get to that point where I can do something I love and be happy with who I am.
It's exciting and it's scary, and I think if you do things that feel a little bit scary or really scary, you learn the most.
These opportunities will come your way, and you can choose to be scared and not take them, or you can just go for it and see what happens. Oh my God, I'm gonna hug you right now. I'm gonna hug you.
I see myself almost becoming a better person by the day because I'm starting to see more things. We still have so many great minds to interact with.
I'm really excited and kind of nervous, but like mostly just like, I'm ready to go.